Five American former prisoners are tonight on their way home thanks to a breakthrough between the US and Iran. For years, their fate was tied to tensions between the two countries, but in the coming hours, politics will take a back seat as they're reunited with loved ones.
A flight to freedom. Five American prisoners touched down in Doha. Embraced by the US ambassador, Murad Tabaz and Ahmad Shaghi, unjustly detained for 5 years in a notorious Tehran prison. Behind bars for nearly 8 years, oil executive Siam Aknamazi made this plea from jail 6 months ago.
The other hostages and I desperately need President Biden to finally hear us out, to finally hear our cry for help and bring us home.
Mr. Tabaz is a wildlife conservationist arrested during a crackdown on environmentalists and showed signs of being tortured for information. His family today said, "We are grateful to President Biden for prioritising the lives of American citizens over politics." 2 years of complicated negotiations, the US and Iran did not speak directly. Instead, Qatar and Oman acted as intermediaries.
Husbands and wives, fathers and children can hug each other again.
The five Americans freed. In exchange, the US government released five Iranians and unblocked the transfer of $9 billion of their frozen oil revenue held in South Korea. Iran can only withdraw the funds for humanitarian purposes.
If there is any diversion, and we will see it, we will lock up these funds again.
Today, US President Joe Biden warned that no American should travel to Iran, but Republicans were quick to criticize, saying the deal incentivized their bad behavior. The White House issuing a new round of sanctions designed to punish those responsible for holding Americans captive. In the United States, Alison Petrowski, 9 News.